Hey everybody, welcome back to another Stellaris Let's Play as the Church of Unity. Let's get right back into it, shall we? Last time we were trying to push out into the last little areas of no man's land. We've got our vapor and moat. Why is that not... The wheat stocks and their neighbors broke off their non-aggression. Okay, you're going to take care of that. You're finishing up with all the debris from the war. How did that get skipped? I don't have a construction ship that's not in the middle of something. So we're only at a third of our total fleet size. And we're at two-thirds of our command limit. But we'll have cruisers coming out in about 5 years, I think. Ooh, longer than that. Why did that jump up? Okay, let's see. And he's even a specialist in that. Okay, you know what we need? Let's see if we've actually got it right now. Yeah, we do have it. We already have research speed bonus. Got two more of these. Then we could get the 10%. I think that's what we'll get next is the 10%. May go for defense after that. Defense isn't all that great. Yeah. Water, however, isn't bad. Armor and hull, shields. Yeah, we might go for order next. What do we get as a emergency cooldown? Subway speed increased by another 10%. And megastructures, build speed, oh, build cost, not speed. And civic slot, let's get a plus one. So yeah, I think we're going to go for honor next. So 60 is 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, no, about 12 years, 12, 13 years before the cruisers are ready. First, we're going to analyze it. And once you're done with that, you can do this. This is going to have to wait for quite some time. movement. That's really a much better system to take. I want that, but it's just not worth what it takes to get there. You need energy. You need consumer goods. Doing on food. You're doing okay on food. Okay. Pirates are okay. Fleet's just chilling out, waiting for the next war to start. When can we actually go to war again? 2282. 7 years. So we're only 3 years into the peace. Yeah, this is the place to put the starbase. That way we can pick up this. We will have to upgrade it pretty quickly, but the first things we need to put there, even though it's the front line, the first things going in are going to be, well, it won't matter until it's upgraded anyway, because you need two trade hubs to reach that. Now, who's riling us? Wait. I thought you already did rival us. Means you guys should like us better now. What if we... Oh, they have us rivaled. We do not have them rivaled. So if we help them in their war effort, we just send them some energy. Who do we have an aggression pact with? So once you're done with that, you need to go all the way back around and get that. May have you pick that up while you're at it. Keep on these. Doesn't say. Need a better name than there we go. That's a better name. Because why not? Keep an eye on our planets. If I do both trade hubs first, because otherwise all I'm going to be getting is 6. Who is he? What's at Star Union? Who is that? If it was them, we would return it immediately. Ah, it's these guys. Let's piss them off even more. Yeah. Yeah, but they have to get through that to get to us. So, you know what? Yeah, we're going to handle them. Yeah, yeah, text of significant cultural importance to the frogs. Lost to pirates years ago, will you return it? No, we think it's bad. No, the written word is the fool of, oh, is the tool of liars. Yeah, this is gonna piss them off, but they're pacifists, so. Yeah, they're not going to be happy with us. Didn't make that much of a difference. Like to see if they rival us. Is that a holy world? No, no, it's not. I don't remember that being there. But we want those moats anyway, so. Guess this little area is going to have to wait until we secure this. Take care of that 1200 first. Also, what's their strength? Inferior economic equivalent everywhere else. You know, I understand it's the mechanic of the game, but the whole idea of closing off these vast areas of space that easily so that no ship can go through just is not realistic. Maybe they need to add a random, based on fleet strength, et cetera, a random, you know, you try and run the border, and you either get caught and turn back, you get into a fight, or your ship gets confiscated, things like that. And then that would also be based on the size of your feet trying to cross the border. How easily you're detected, how hard it is for them to take your ships. Yes, it's a lot of coding, but it would make a hell of a lot more sense. Hear that paradox? This does not make sense. Any more than your storyline of saying, well, the only reason we took out all the other modes of travel is because we wanted to make sure everybody was involved in the terrain of the map. Sorry, no matter which of the original three modes of transportation you use, you still have to cross systems, which means you're still going to have to land in a system, which means you're still going to have to deal with terrain. One additional housing. Let's do the housing first. Now, don't get me wrong, I still love the game. I just don't think that was a great idea or fair to all the players who bought the game and who wanted a game with that type of diversity. That's what was great about early Stellaris. And yes, so many people just love hyperlanes and love the choke points and everything else. I like wormhole travel. That was my favorite mode of transportation for my empires. And you say, oh, well, we still have wormholes in the game. We still have gateways in the game. Yeah, you do, but it's not the same. And, you know, certain things like the total conversion for the Star Trek mod, it's somewhat pointless if you have to go through hyperlanes because they don't exist in that universe. Which is why you had warp drive in the game in the first place. I really miss that diversity. I'll get off my soapbox now and get back to colonizing. That's it, everybody go to Paradox.
And hashtag bring back wormhole travel.
Oh, that's one I am colonizing. Am I building another? No, that's the one that's being colonized. That's Orc World. Orkistani. Orkistani Prime. Hey, you know something we probably don't have on a lot of these planets? So busy trying to get them the way they're supposed to be. They need temples. Need a lot more minerals on this planet. This is a crappy planet when it comes to minerals. Why did it even colonize this world? Where is Cruel Prime? These I took from the enemy. Who is down here? Why did I colonize this world? Really don't see a good reason for colonizing this world at all. How big is it? Size 15. 3,000, yes, we definitely want to extend that. We need the plus 10%. ~42 months until we finish off this tree. Really debating whether to go with Discovery or with Order. Either way, those will probably be the next two. I just don't know in which I'm going to do first. I like what Order has in it, but I... you know what? Let's just take the influence. I just want that extra 10% research. Just like I only want whatever diplomacy is called for us for the 10% reduction in market costs. Speaking of which, yeah. Oh, we have the galactic market. Okay. If we sell 1,000 minerals and buy 1 little bit more of that, never have too many alloys. While we're sitting here, let's go ahead and upgrade those. We should be set for auto. Let's look in our ship designer. are set to auto. Let's get rid of this. Maybe because they're not Incheon class. No, they are now, for sure. Everybody's so busy doing their things. Okay, so what do we need over here? We need food. And we need consumer goods. Got 2 of 4. So that's just starting. As soon as we get that done, we're going to have to colonize it. Build a second fleet over here to protect against both of these. So let's get 2 trade hubs, then we'll upgrade, and we'll add hangar bay, and then a shipyard. And by then, hopefully we'll have both of these systems. So that went for 1 more starbase. Let's see if there's anything I can actually get rid of. We don't have the bonus for trade hubs. We need to research that. This is at a point. All tile blockers removed. Let's change that. So we don't need a shipyard here right now. And if we can get Forex trade, I'm going to go ahead and build that first. Just to fill us in. I'm not going to worry about those two yet. I want this first. Weak and natural beauty. There's a pair. Good mining world. That one will be done first. entirely. It'll be done first. We are in fourth place. Because apparently third place doesn't exist. They Monty Python the score. Build, build, and build. And then move back. Build that. And then build that. Push towards that Gaia planet, and we will fill in some of these little gaps here. Then we'll come back and get this chunk. But after that, we're going to have to choose a target, because we're pretty much out of space. We've got a few systems down here, but that's not going to take us anywhere, because that's a full empire. But we need to turn our attention to them again. And from there, we'll have a border with the Weed Empire. But that will have to come later, because as usual, we are out of time. So if you like this video, hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe and hit that bell so you get notification of all our upcoming Juicy Stellaris content. And check out the channel for all our other gaming videos and tutorials. But as always, as for me, I am done, and we are out of here. We'll see you in the next one. Thank you.